We figured out that you like ghosts and goblins and such. When it comes to spine-tingling fun, there's never too much. Some ghosts are legend, others myth or history. Some ghosts are fun or terrifying or just plain mystery.
You never really know what to expect from ghosts. Sometimes you see them, and sometimes you don't. Sometimes you can only photograph them, but most of the time, we only hear stories about ghosts.
Over half the people in the United States have had either personally or in their family some sort of ghost experience.
Clarence Dye is neither a believer nor a non-believer in the spirit world, but he has heard a lot of ghost stories.
I don't know how it got started, but I know that those hitchhiker stories are, they pop up about once every year in a different section of the country.
The story goes like this. It's a damp and misty night. A man is driving down a dark, lonely road and spots a woman hitchhiking. He stops and offers her a ride. They get to talking, and he finds out that she lives just a few blocks away, so he offers to take her to her door. As they pull up in front of her house, she turns to say goodnight and vanishes. She's gone, except for her jacket. He grabs the coat and rushes to the door. Yes, they recognize the coat. It belongs to their daughter. Their daughter who was killed a year ago while hitchhiking.
Tales like The Hitchhiker really send a chill up your spine, even though they're more folklore than fact. But there is a documented ghost story that took place right here on the Buffalo State College campus in the fall of 1976.
A story about Wendy Sternberg, who was at that time a student. One day between classes, she went to get her student ID made. She filled out her form and then sat for a photo.
Okay, Wendy, smile.
So they gave Wendy her ID card, but she didn't look at it right away. She was in a hurry to get to her next class, so she just took the card and stuck it in her purse.
And behind her in the picture is a little lady. Sum it up, the little lady was never there.
Wendy gave the ID card to Clarence Dye to see if he could unravel the mystery. The professor explored every possibility. His detective work even included calling the factory where the film was made. His conclusion?
When we got right down to it, we had to tell her that we didn't have an answer. Again, you know, who says we've got to have an answer for everything in life?
Ghosts usually come looking for you, but you'll never know when. Here in Western New York, there are a few brave souls who go looking for them.
The tiny church is situated on a dead-end street, but the members of the First Spiritualist Temple believe that as far as the human spirit is concerned, there is no dead end.
The name Edna calls out to you, please, from spirit. Would you understand
that?
Yes, and would you please understand a lady with a French accent?
Yes.
This is the first time in its 75-year history that cameras have been allowed in this church to record a message service. It is in these weekly get-togethers that mediums like Charlene Kleinschmidt give messages to members of the congregation from friends and relatives who have passed away.
I also hear the name Elizabeth call to you, but she was called Betty when she was on the earth plane.
What goes on in this church every Sunday night could be called a seance. So there is nothing spooky about spiritualism, and it would be very nice if people would find that out for themselves.
Whether you find communicating with dead relatives spooky or just plain hard to believe, it's interesting to note that most of the members here were at one time skeptics.
Shortly after I became a spiritualist, my grandmother had a coronary and she died.
Tom Arthur was convinced about spiritualism when at a service like this one, a medium gave him a detailed message from his grandmother describing a personal childhood incident.
There's no way it could have been faked.
Throughout the years, spiritualists have been called witches and even devil worshippers. They don't appear to be either. They are convinced that mediums do communicate with spirits, an ability which should not be taken lightly or practiced by amateurs.
But it is something that people should not play around with unless they know what they're doing.
Coming up, a couple of real haunted houses right here in Western New York. Meanwhile, you may want to make sure yours isn't.